For the Park World Championships 2023 Rome, Ostia. We are here to see the top eight skaters in both men's and women's go head-to-head, where later today, two world champions will be crowned. This is the road to Paris 2024, where we see the world's best skaters building up those important qualifying points to make the cut to represent their countries in the Olympics. We started our world skateboarding tour in San Juan, Argentina, with an amazing park competition. We then came to Rome and on to Lausanne for our street competitions. And now we find ourselves back in Rome for the Park World Championships. Our next event will be the Street World Championships in Japan, and then we take it back to Sharjah in the UAE for both park and street events. Coming up on today's schedule, we have all the action from women's and men's finals. We catch up with Augusto Akio and Ruby Trew. Plus, Sakura, Yosozumi and Stephen Pinheiro share some insights on this World Championship bowl. And remember, you can join the conversation on social media by searching at WorldSkateSB. I'm Mark Churchill. I'm very happy to say that joining me on the platform of this amazing bowl is artist, co-founder of Stereo Skateboards and all-round skateboarding legend, Mr. Chris Pastras.
Thank you, Mark. You're too kind. I love that. And I love working with you, so I'm honored to be here in Rome. We've got the best park training skaters in the world. This is the last big competition of 2023. Tons on the line leading up to Tokyo 2024.
Yeah, and we've got a higher point scoring going on here at the World Championships,
yeah,
right?
Big time. I mean, normally you get 50,000 points for first. It's now 80,000 points. So yeah. 60% higher. A lot on the line.
Yeah, for sure.
Careers are on the line.
What a great bowl we've got behind us, mate.
Yeah, I got to say, it's kind of more compact and fun. It's not super big, so easy flow. They got the spine ramp from the 80s. I'm feeling it.
And we've got the top eight men, top eight women from yesterday's 190 over the weekend, right?
Yeah, I mean, these guys have been here since Monday, most of them. A couple of them have come out early to practice. So, yeah, they've been putting in work, and it's going to show.
And the thing that stands out to me on the platform, we're seeing younger and younger riders, and Ruby Trew's one of those ones that stands out to me,
man,
right?
Yeah, she is one of those ones. Every competition, there's a new face, a new name that blows my mind, and she's one of them for sure.
Yeah, and speaking of Ruby, we caught up a little bit earlier to have a chat.
It's my second time here. I came here a few weeks ago to practice, and I love it here. The food here is, like, really great because it's just pasta, pizza, and gelato, like, my three favorite things. So, yeah, I definitely love it here, and the park here is super fun as well. The people that run the Spot Skatepark are amazing. Love skating with all, like, the Italian kids, all pushing each other. So, yeah, I can't wait to see how the comp goes. Being in the pre-seated is great because you can practice and no one will be getting in your way, and all the girls there, like, know what they're doing, so no snaking, and yeah, it's just a gift you get given, so you got to take advantage of it. San Juan was a really good event for me because I came second and I did my best run, I put it down. It's just a really great experience overall, and to be skating with all my friends was the best bit. Stay good in surfing and skating at the same time is really hard. I mean, they're quite similar sports because you're both on boards, but obviously it's different because in surfing you have to read the ocean and be able to, like, know what's happening, when in skating the ball's the same, it's just up to how consistent you are. So it is different, but it's not, like, totally different. My advice would be don't give up on what you're trying, because there's going to be ups and downs. And you just got to push through and, yeah, get done. We have to get done.
So good to hear from Ruby there, Chris. But unfortunately, she didn't make the cut to today's final, right?
Yeah, that's a tough one. She skated so well. And I love how younger women mix in old school tricks like that frontside board slide with new tricks. So hats off to Ruby Trew. She laid it all out there.
Yeah, and yesterday's semifinals was absolutely bonkers, right?
Yeah, I mean, it felt like a final, so I'm just anticipating what's going to happen. I've seen people try some surprise things in practice, so it's going to be good.
And speaking of our semifinals, it's time to introduce the third member of our team and hear from Samantha Bruce about how our semifinals went down.
The semi-finals are the most brutal stage of the competition, reducing the field from 16 to 8 coming into the finals. Grace Marhofer was solid and consistent all week, but couldn't complete a full run in the semis, rolling off a frontside grind to end her chances. San Juan's second place Ruby Trew and X Games winners Arisa Trew threw down McTwists in their runs but didn't make the cut for a chance at the World Championship podium spot. Naya Lasso, Lily Sofasius and Bryce Wettstein made up the top three of heat number one, biting their nails as stacked heat two went down. Promising newcomer Lily Erickson couldn't hang on to a kickflip indie at the end of her last two runs, which would have been enough to progress. Olympic champion Sakura Yosozumi.
There, our timer is counted down. That means practice is over and we are ready to get our first rider ready to drop in. That will be Lily. Pretty much throwing caution to the wind,
yeah,
and just going, I can't do the safety run.
No, you really can't. You know, some skaters do the basics just to get warmed up, but it's not going to put you on podium, that's for sure.
Oh,
you
lovely
do some super
back three.
Tricks.
Just missing the backside blunt. That would have been just on the buzzer. Oh,
literally
wow.
On the buzzer.
Walking away, all smiles, but that's going to be a heavy score regardless, I think. Just missing that last trick, but you do seem to get pretty hurt on when those scores come in if you do fall.
Yeah, definitely. We haven't seen anybody really move on in competition with a fall, at least
and,
in semis.
We heard from Renton Miller earlier, you know, he's saying we don't want to see anyone falling.
Yeah. Yeah, he also mentioned the repetition of tricks, and that's important as well.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, 76.46. Great score with a fall there, Chris.
Yeah, so by that, what I mean is the judges want to see new tricks. They don't want to see you do the same run you did in qualifying or semifinals.
Okay, we heard from her earlier. Run number one of three for Sakura Yosozumi.
I love the start. Oh no.
Missing
she
the
had that every single time.
Yeah.
She did a sugar cane into that nose blunt times yesterday. That's what happens.
But
a lot of pressure.
First run nerves at the World Championships, Chris.
Yes.
Getting an 8.06 for dropping in, technically. That's a great score.
Yeah, Sakura doesn't back away from any pressure, though. I think she'll be fine.
Okay, we're taking it over to the USA and Minas Des. In first, Mina was looking so solid in practice today.
Yeah, Mina's one of my favorites. She's got like a really cool style. You know, mixes vert, street, mini ramp. She skates everything. And coming out of Northern California, which I love, coming out of Petaluma. Nice 5-0.
Frontside grind through that corner. Backside ollie over the hip, getting that speed and pumping those corners.
Yeah, she looks confident in this run.
Yeah, love that ollie up to lip slide. You can see.
There's that volcano.
Yeah, Mina tweaks all of her grabs as well, and I think that's what the judges want to see. That shows full control of the air.
Yeah, and I love the ollie board slide, making some old school tricks count.
Taking the backside air over into that indie air over the hip.
Like you mentioned.
Smith stopped falling out, but staying on. Solid run there for Minas Des. That's our first complete run so far.
Yeah, I mean, from what I can see, opposite from what I said, people are kind of starting off with like a safety run, which is not a bad thing to do because then you can just build on your scores. Save all the 540s for third run.
I mean, that's one thing that's blowing me away at the moment is the amount of 540s we're seeing go down in every run. It's crazy, or most runs.
And the amount of kickflip grabs you see in the field with women, it's pretty nutty. It's amazing. Like her style. She's already thinking about the landing as she hit the coping.
And something that I find crazy is everyone can time their runs perfectly. Okay, 84.55.
Wow,
that's a big
amazing
score for it.
Yes.
Yeah, so the timing of the runs, you know, 45 seconds seems so little, but they're cramming so many tricks in, and they're getting the last trick on the buzzer.
Yeah, and we're noticing, even though this is a bowl, the judges are docking you for just carving through the corners and doing scratch grinds. You got to hit every wall in this contest, in this park.
So Ruby Lily in from the USA, run one of three. Oh, nice. Tweaking that backside air, so good. Lean up to disaster.
Oh, yes.
Smacking that back truck round.
Ooh, nice nose grind. Yeah, Ruby.
Really solid nose grind there. Carving those corners, getting that speed back in.
Nice 5-0. Backside Smith. What you going to end with? The Andrect.
Coming down right to those last few seconds. There's that cross-slide revert. Fakey Ollie.
Yes.
So similar run to what we saw in qualifiers and semifinals, Chris.
Yeah, 100%. It's interesting, too, like the crail slide revert. I wonder to myself sometimes, where does a 16-year-old learn that trick?
Yeah, I mean, that trick's been around for a long, long time.
Dates back to the 80s, so I'm stoked on seeing that mix up with new and old.
They certainly do, Ruby. So there's those replays. Check out that tweak backside air. So good.
Yeah, and then she did that lean disaster.
There's that
nice
fakey ollie.
Yeah.
And that backside
that
nose grind, really,
yes,
really well done. You see how controlled her feet were on that?
For sure. Yeah, and she's kind of inside the park or the rope bowl, so that makes it even more difficult, I think.
I mean, it's worth saying, up in that judges booth, we have Pat Duffy, an absolute skateboard legend. So they see all those little nuances and they see everything. And an 80.40 coming through for run number one.
Yeah, and head judge Renton Miller, Ripper.
So we are taking it to Spain and Naya Lasso. I was speaking to Alain Goikuchea earlier, coach for Team Spain. Woo. And he said they are so stoked to be into the final and it's all or nothing, but the hard work's already been done to get through. So, you know, that only backs us up what we were saying earlier. To get through to this point of the competition was so hard.
Yeah, and that was a great blunt up the bank wall extension.
Woo.
Is that grind a board slide? That's a unique one. That's like a curb trick. Nice back Smith. Skating very confident. Oh, 5-0 to Fakie through the corner.
Looking super smooth.
L twist. All right.
Backside ollie back out on the hip. There's the backside disaster to see
it
off.
Wow.
Right, so they're sticking true to what Alain was saying earlier. He was saying, yeah, going to stick with a similar run that we did yesterday. Get that run down. Get the score on the board.
Dial it in.
And then she's going to spice it up a little bit. And I can't wait to see what she's got in store for us.
Yeah, that's the interesting thing about competitions is you'll notice the most competitive skaters try to hold a couple tricks that you haven't seen even in practice.
Yeah, they want to wow those judges.
Yeah.
The judges want to go, oh, okay, they are stepping the game up.
For sure. The judges want to see you push yourself. Very clean run.
Yeah, solid run there. So 86.25, new leader.
Wow.
All right. Wow. So next driver out from Brazil.
Okay, it's now time to take it over to Brazil. Rika Ventura.
Yeah, Rika's got a good style, powerful skater.
Taking that line off of the platform onto the big flat bank, backside 5-0 over the love seat. Lovely indie air into the deep end. Chris, this is shaping up to be great so far.
Yeah, so far, man. She's got to stay on. Oh, I like the front 50-50 off the extension.
But you know what? There's a hip there.
Yeah.
And she lands perfectly in it to shoot herself around that corner pocket on the spine. So good.
That Japan air is one of the highest airs we've seen so far.
Yeah, boosting that one. Alley-oop backside ollie back onto the flat bank.
This is a great run.
Front
final
grind.
Seconds. Back Smith.
Back into the deep end for the last trick. Feeble grind to Fakie. So, rule is, Chris, if you've committed and your board is fully on the wall that you're going to do the trick on, it counts.
Yeah, I believe that was in
time. If the buzzer goes off.
Yeah. People riding a fakie through that ball corner. She's stoked.
So yesterday we had a guest in the booth, Corbin. He said he couldn't find a seat on the stands out there for semi. So there is not one seat out there in those stands. And there's a lot of seats available. And there's also a queue right round the block to get in today.
Yeah, and I mean, if you could feel or hear the crowd and the energy, it's something else, man. Rome is pumped. Is that alley-oop backside ollie?
The speed like generated then to ollie up to frontside lip slide.
Yeah,
that's so
difficult.
Good.
Difficult little line there.
Feeble grind to fakie.
Yeah, ending things
through
off.
Through the corner. Waiting for that score to come in. 87.59.
Wow,
new
shocked
leader.
Herself.
Look at her face. So good. Awesome.
Hey, that shows she's humble.
Fully deserved, though, Chris.
Yeah,
so stoked.
For sure. Full power. I love it.
That Brazilian legacy of skateboarding all from the very beginning of competitions, really, all the way through to now.
Passion, baby.
So we are in to our second place qualifier.
Wow,
Hinano
wraparound
kicking
air.
It off.
I haven't seen that trick in a long time. Woo. Oh, that board slide.
Almost too fast into that, I think, Chris.
Yeah, man. She's been doing that every time. I'm expecting her to put that together for round number two.
But that builds up a bit of tension now because everyone's thinking, okay, you've switched up your line. What have you got in store for us?
Yeah, I mean, if you try to keep it basic and you fall, you're pretty set back.
Okay. Up next, we have our first place qualifier through from semifinals from Japan. Kokona Araki.
Yeah, Kokona. She had a slam right before the competition, so hope she's recovered from that.
There
oh,
it
I
is.
Love that.
Straight into that big backside nose grind.
The way she stands up on that thing, it's like I've never seen anybody do a backside nose grind like that.
And it's every go as well, and that consistency is so important at this level of competition.
She stands up on it like it's a bench. Nice trail slide. Yeah, Kokona.
Back into the deep end, front nose grind
front
through
side.
The corner. The front difficulty level is definitely there, Chris.
Okay, I think I know what she's going for. Nice smith grind over the spine. I'm going to try to fit in a flip trick, I bet.
Back in through the corner.
Could be wrong there. Stalefish revert, all right.
Sneaking that in on the buzzer. You can certainly see why she was at our first place qualifier yesterday.
Yeah, she's just got such a like laid-back, cool style.
And speaking to Renton, yesterday, I believe, he was saying, you know, we want to see people using all parts of this bowl. It's got so many different things on it.
Yeah.
And he's saying, they're there, use them.
Yep.
And you're going to get scored well if you do. There's that frontside nose grind.
Nice backside ollie. That was like blink. Trail slide revert. Here's that nose grind
nose
we talked
grind.
About.
Look at that. I love the way that she pops out of that and knows that she's landed it and already looking up at the bank. Ready for the next hit. 92.08. We're already in the 90s on run number one, Chris.
I'll tell you what, that was well deserved.
And we are taking it back to the top of the heat for runs number two of three. Chance for a bit of redemption for any of the riders that haven't made a complete ride so far. Lily Stofasius, one of those.
As the runs move on, the pressure mounts.
Backside 5-0 over the love seat to kick it off. Backside ollie onto the bank.
Nice, Delfish. Ooh, the finger from lean the tail. Nice addition there.
That one for Klaus Grabke.
Yep.
And the music. There's the frontside lip slide through that corner.
15. Get it, Lily.
Lily got eighth in the finals at San Juan as well, so very
nice
familiar
judo.
With the pressure of World Championships. Backside disaster. 1 second remaining. Frontside grind to see it off. Solid run.
Yeah,
I can see what 100%. She did there. Went, okay, I need to get a full completed run on the board. And then she's got one last chance to step it up. Jürgen Harwolf there, giving a big hug. An absolute vert legend.
In the early 90s, Germany.
It's that big frontside lip slide through the corner.
Keeping her speed, that alley-oop air on the volcano.
And straight into that backside disaster. There's that stale fish. Woo. So styly there.
Hanging on by her toes.
Yeah, and landing really high up the transition to keep that speed. We're waiting for that run. Two score of three. 82-18. Okay. Right. So, currently sitting in that fifth place position.
Yeah, there's some meat left on the bone there. She can do a little more.
So we're taking it back to Japan and Sakura Yosozumi.
Yeah, one of the most decorated park skaters in the women's field right here. There we go.
Getting it done this time. That's going to build the confidence, get that out of the way, and build on the run from there. Feeble grind on the 30-second mark.
She is an Olympic gold medalist. Do not be surprised.
Lovely nice backside ollie there.
That was floaty. Back tail.
15 seconds remaining. Looking pretty composed so far, Chris.
The backside 360 ollie. I think she's just trying to stay on, which she's doing a great job of. Sugarcane there. It's an old school lip trick.
Yeah, just hanging on that back wheel. Ooh, there's the back nose blunt. Reva.
She needed that.
Yeah, definitely. You could see she was really happy to get that done. Hands in the air.
Yeah, there's so much like thought and practice that comes into doing a trick like that, a backside nose blunt revert with like 1 second on the clock. It's amazing.
There's nothing quite like skateboarding. It will let you land that run every go in practice, and then you can drop in, and it takes over and goes, nah, not now.
Not today.
It's always in control. Let's check out those replays.
She's got to be stoked after run number one and stepping it up. There's that alley-oop ollie. She goes kind of straight up and down. There's that sugar cane.
So confident in her style, and this is how we saw the eight run finished off. Back nose blunt, back 7-8 in the revert. Yeah, you see that back wheel just catching the coping.
Yeah, that's a difficult lip trick. She's quite a lip trick master.
Yeah, I mean, we heard earlier from her, loves the mini ramps. That's where she comes from, but has been taking those maneuvers into this bowl here. 83.53 coming in. Happy with that one.
All right. Yeah, she's got more left.
So run number two for Minestes. Starting off in that position again. Going to be launching it out onto that steep flat bank. That's a good way to start. I feel like that would feel really nice and get that speed up without wasting too much time.
Yeah, those first couple tricks in general. High speed. Ollie up to Smith grind. Yeah. Yeah, Mina.
I like that line. Up into the deep end and then out of the deep end back into the midsection.
Yeah. She's a fun one to follow on Instagram. She's like constantly skating. I think her brother skates. Her family's super supportive. They go everywhere with her. Great story.
Indy, backside blunt. And then getting that line back around that corner pocket.
There it is. The ollie up to board side. Got to stay on here.
You can hear the wheels hitting the coping.
There it is.
Oh, yes.
Gets to the kickflip Indy.
Done.
With 2 seconds on the clock.
Yes.
And you can hear the crowd roar.
And you can see she is so hyped to get that done. So are we in the booth.
Yeah.
Wow.
I mean,
so good.
I think people have been holding back on the kickflips or the flips in general and even the 540s. They want to get a score on the board. And then we saw Minna just step it up and adding some super difficult tricks.
As you can see there, the camaraderie on the bowl platform is incredible. People going up and hugging people that might well knock them out of the competition.
Yeah,
nobody cares because skateboarding always wins.
Yeah, you're not going to see that in a basketball game or a football game. The players talking each other up, slapping each other high fives, giving them advice.
There's that kickflip Indy. So perfect. Landing bolts, both feet above the trucks of the board. So good.
Coach Trevor Ward with her. See what she gets.
Waiting for that score to come in. All eyes are on that scoreboard right now.
You can tell the judges are thinking.
Yeah.
When there's a pause like that, there's some conversations, deliberations.
Yeah, and I mean, they are so technical with their scoring. They know exactly where people need to be in the heat and, you know, what other people have done. And they reference that and go back and say, no, you know what? This was an improvement. 90.80. Trevor's happy.
Wow. That's awesome.
Wow, that is the silver medal position there at the moment.
Two perfect, amazing runs there.
90.80. Great score there for Nina Stess. And we now take it over to compatriot Ruby Lilly.
Yeah, only 16 years old. Originally from Ocean City, Maryland. Kind of near where I grew up.
And Chris, this is her first final as well.
Is that right?
Yes.
It doesn't
looking
seem
really
like it.
Composed.
She's skating so dominant. Wow.
Yes. Getting the ollie up to front side nose grind. That's so gnarly, Chris. Really difficult trick to do.
Back nose grind.
That's two nose grinds.
A lot differently than Kokona, but they're both rad in their own way.
Standing up on the front side grind. Backside Ooh. Smith. That was a
rail
much
hit.
Better backside Smith that
yeah,
time.
Yeah, you heard her rail hit the coping. Nice Andrecht, named after my buddy Dave Andrecht.
Rolling back into that deep end. Feeble grind to fakie.
There we go.
Chris, that run seemed to be way better timed.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
As soon as the nose grind happened, everything else seemed to just fall into place,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, place. Yep, 100%. Very, very confident.
Really, really happy.
It's great to see the relief on these girls' faces when they do everything they set out to do.
Yeah, for sure.
That
there
nose
you go.
Grind up the extension.
Got a good, decent length of grind on there as well.
Yeah, that was solid. Howie, backside disaster here.
And there's that backside Smith grind. You see that back toe holding it in the grind. The front foot just pointing it forward. So good execution.
Yeah,
we're waiting
judges
for that run
with,
two score to come through.
With
for
inverts,
Ruby.
They want to see the hands on coping.
Yeah.
So she did put her hand on the coping with that Andrecht.
84.40.
Wow. Okay.
Sees
okay.
her in fifth place. Here or there, that's better than I thought.
Dude, it's amazing to even make it to the stage of the competition.
Yeah.
There's been four, this is the fourth level.
Yeah.
Qualifying, it's been a long quarterfinals, semifinals, finals. Boom.
So, Spaniard Naya Lasso dropping in for run number two. Frontside Smith grind, so smooth on that.
Yeah, and the gap's closing between the scores. Everyone's putting in really good runs right now.
Oh, changing that slide up, Chris. We saw that little stale fish tickle up to frontside lip slide and then the back Smith. Back tail, and now that back Smith from 50-50.
Trying to step
okay,
it up.
I think
up.
I know what she's going to go for here.
What she got?
Getting the speed up to come back over that love seat. Let's see it. Get it done, Naya. Close. 5-0 fakie. That's
she
the one she's been working on in practice.
A little more speed. We've seen her make that.
And there's only one more chance to get that done. I think everyone's going to go crazy if that gets landed. No one else is doing that one.
Yeah, and it shows you how long of a grind that is over that love seat.
There's a line giving some words of encouragement. You've got it, Naya.
Yes.
Okay. Our next rider up is going to be Rika Ventura
16 years of age.
From Brazil. Run number two of three.
Rika is another one whose father skates. Probably where she got all that confidence. Placed third in San Juan with us. Nice start. That backsmith is no joke over that love seat.
Loving that line to get over that hip. Such a good backside air there as well.
Oh no,
and stepping away from the frontside air. You could see her, she was knee sliding out then, like,
yeah.
What? How
Why did
that
I fail that? She's all smiles though.
But that means the pressure's on. Currently in third place. Qualified in third place, but definitely wants to start stepping it up and got one last chance to do that.
Yeah, that's for sure. And even though she's in third, everything can change.
Please clear the course, thank you.
So, We're taking it back to Japan and Hinano Kasaki. 45 seconds and run 2 of 3. Rolling in backside.
Yeah, she's only 15 years old, so amazing. Nice wrap around there.
Backside ollie onto the bank, taking it through to the deep end. Okay, that's there's where she fell.
Side. Yeah,
on
she
run
got
number
it.
One.
It's got to give her the confidence to move on.
Back into that deep end.
There we go.
You hear the crowd erupting for that huge 540, yeah.
Nice Smith grind, powerful.
I think that's 3 hits in the deep end already. See how fast she's skating.
She got 4th in San Juan, so she knows how to put it together.
Ooh. Oh, wow.
That was crazy. Nice, Andrek. Backside crown.
Oh,
wow.
Getting the full right. run this time.
With that massive 540, yeah, I'd say that's a podium run for sure.
But, Chris, what about use of course, mate? Seemed to spend a lot of time in the deep end.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I think it suits her style. She seems to be more of a vert skater. But I don't know, man. Doing that huge 540, I'd say that was worth the price of admission.
Yeah, we're going to find out what the judges think of that very soon. Let's check out those replays. There's yeah. that big
props
old board slide rock and roll.
Jeff Grasso, RIP. Board sliding all the way through that corner, like you said, Mark.
There's big that 540.
Yeah, huge. No hesitation.
Backside grab. 540. Good release on that and landing super high up on that transition to be able to maintain that speed. And she's a
back
fast
rail.
Skater.
Yeah, and you named it. She did some unique tricks on the big coping. On the deep ends, actually.
So let's see what those judges think of that. Looking pretty nervous, waiting for that to come through. 93.20,
wow.
And your new leader, 93.20,
that
Chris.
Is, wow. I mean, that shows you the power of a 540 right
yeah.
there. The rest of her run was great as well, but that powerful backside 540.
But linking lip tricks with air tricks, 540s. That's obviously what the judges want to see.
Amen to that.
So first place qualifier, run number 2. Already had a great run. Kokona Hiraki back in. Straight into that big backside nose grind.
Signature backside
over the love seat.
Nose grind. She does that trick better than anyone in the men or women's field. And there's that kick flip.
No grab. On that.
Yeah. That's the one I thought she was going to hold on to till now. And smart move.
I think this is a definite reaction right now to the run we just saw.
Nose grind. All right.
India.
10. I love that spine transfer. Not many people are using that obstacle. You talked about use of course.
Yeah, pretty much every obstacle hit right now. Are we going to see onto the flat bank? Yes, we are.
Yeah.
Stale revert.
Stalefish. Revert. We'll take it.
So, first run was that, but a little less spicy. This time, stepped up. That backside kick flip was incredible.
Yeah,
it was
huge,
right up
huge
the
huge difference with the backside flip. No-handed, which is really difficult in big transition.
So we'll wait for that score to come in.
He's got to be happy with that.
There you go. There's that backside kickflip. That's out
Lick.
Of the coping. Wow.
Yeah. Amazing.
And the stale.
Final trick. Reaver. Final wall.
You could see the relief. She was like, yes, I did it. And that front side nose grind every time around that corner.
Nose grind master.
So we're waiting for that score to come in before we take it back to the top of the heat. 94.54.
Wow.
Do you know what? Those judges are saying that backside kickflip is as gnarly as we're saying.
Yeah. I mean, it's quarter. You know, 2.5 extra points right there.
No grabs. Sad to go on the top of the order. Third and final runs here in the women's quarterfinals.
So we're taking it back to Germany for last runs. Run 3 of 3 for Lily Stofasius. Yeah. Let's see it, Lily. Last chance
has
to
step
get
it
on
up.
That podium.
All skaters have a score in the 80s, so that tells you something about the level of what's going down right now. She's on the 82.18, and she's in eighth place.
There's that stale fish. Finger flip, lean to tail. Backside Smith grind. It's all going to plan so far. Frontside lip slide. Yeah, I'd say that was a little bit better than the last run. Landed a little bit squirrely on that backside ollie, but keeping the speed up. Keep it going, Lily, down to the last 10 seconds, Chris.
Yes, this is it. Barrel air. Okay. Big alley-oop air on the volcano.
Ooh. Yes, getting
that,
it done
this
time.
That was a great combination.
Wow.
That was three bangers
Lily, right there. You can
so
see
sick.
Jürgen smiling and clapping there. So stoked. Amazing.
Those last three tricks were so tight.
Yeah. We saw Lily fall on run number one at the backside blunt, so definitely coming back on that one and getting it done again for the final run. All eyes are on that board now, waiting for that last score to come in.
That backside 270 straight into that blunt.
And the varial there in the deep end.
Yeah, there was that three-wall combination that was just boom, boom, boom.
Yeah, back to back. What a world championship so far, Chris.
Yeah, seriously.
Amazing.
Look at her score is just climbing up, sort of how the progression's happening.
Yeah, for sure. And we're waiting for that third and final score to come in for Lily Stofasius. 84.79, jumping up two positions into that sixth place position.
Got to be proud of herself. Like I said, just making finals in a competition this heavy is no joke.
And someone someone I would expect to see on the platform at our World Championships is Sky Brown. Some people might be asking where she is. Unfortunately, she had an injury just before the competition. So get well soon, Sky.
Yeah, get well soon, Sky.
So Sakura back in for third and final run. It's looking good so far.
Pressure is on. Currently in eighth place with a landed run. So she's got a feeble grind. We didn't see that in the first run or second run.
Backside ollie onto the bank. There's the backside air.
Going for the heel flip indie.
Yeah.
That was smart,
stepping
though.
The run up, though. She knew that that's what it's going to take to be able 100%. To get up into that podium position. You know, our podium currently is a 90.80, a 93.20, and a 94.54. So dropping in then, it was like, I've got to do the heel flip indie if I want any chance of getting anywhere near
it. At this point, you got to have a 540 or a kick flip or something, something spectacular, at least to crack the podium.
So 34.71 and remaining in that eighth place position. So next rider up, currently in the bronze medal position. Run number three and third and final run for Ministess. 90.80 on the board. Where's she going to go from there, Chris?
She's got a pretty deep bag of tricks. I mean, currently in third place. I think she's going to have to go a little bit higher, a little bit more gnarly, maybe add a technical flip trick.
Well, knowing with the other riders coming up as well, you can be toppled off of that podium position, right? Really easily.
Yeah, we saw her get to that kickflip grab at the end of her run. So hopefully she gets to that again and adds something else spicy.
Oh, so styly on that ollie up to lip slide. The indie air over the teardrop volcano. Back blunt on the bank.
All right, what you got here? Ollie up to board side every time.
Oh no! Oh, sticking on the backside Smith grind.
It's crazy when that happens. Someone does like an amazing run and then falls on a 50-50.
Yeah. That's skateboarding for you.
Yeah.
But now Mina has to sit and watch because that's not going to be a better score. 73.04 and has to sit and watch to see if she's going to get bumped out of that bronze medal position.
Does that stick?
I really hope so. It'd be great to see her on the podium. So.
Santa Cruz represent.
Yeah.
All right, well, she put that second run down.
I mean, that's a great score with a fall, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So, teammate Ruby Lilly, run number 3 of 3. Highest score so far, 84.40. Come on, Ruby. Let's
Pressure's
see what you've
on.
Got.
Pressure is on. For all the marbles. Get it, Ruby.
Carving up that wall to get the speed for that backside air.
She got that pump into the next backside air. Got to avoid not hitting walls.
Yeah, staying on that frontside nose grind.
Nice nose grind.
Got that backside nose grind so dialed. It's great to see. There's that stand up frontside 5-0. Backside Smith grind.
There's that Andrek. Is she going to add anything? All right.
Need to see something different now. Oh, going for the twist, but not quite getting the speed to get that one done.
I mean, seriously, none of these girls have anything to be ashamed of. They've skated so well.
Oh, the level is through the roof, Chris.
Yeah.
It's so amazing to see. 77.43 coming through. Ruby staying in that seventh place position. Okay, fourth place qualifier through to our final up next. Out of Spain, we have Naya Lasso.
Yeah, only Spanish rider in the finals.
Ollie now onto that bank. Frontside Smith grind to start it off. Same run so far, Chris.
Ooh, she went for a stale fish to lip.
I really wanted to see the 5-0 to fakie over the love seat.
Yeah.
Just drop in and do it for us.
Seriously.
Great skating from Naya the whole weekend, and currently sitting in fifth place is a really good place to be.
Yeah, most of these women and men have been here since Monday, just powering through, getting used to this park.
And remember, Chris, high scoring points. You know,
yes.
This is a high scoring event. So just getting in that final means that you're bumping your scores up that go towards the Olympics
100%.
Massively.
Yeah, Kokona Haraki could potentially get 80,000 points.
So next rider up from Brazil, Rika Ventura, the last rider that can possibly shake up that podium, Chris.
Yeah, get it, Rika. She definitely has the moves. She's got to stay on.
Backside Smith, Brian. In the
nice.
Air, into the deep.
Powerful backside air. And we saw her fall on a frontside air earlier. She makes it.
Oh, changing the run up, making it a Smith grind this time over the hip. Stepping down off that extension. Now into the deep end.
Huge.
Oh, no.
Huge Japan air. Just came off her feet.
You can see everyone pushing it as much as they can, but that means Ministes is getting that bronze medal, third place. Wow, so stoked.
Yeah, she is in tears.
so happy for us. Great to see. So we've still got our top two qualifiers
to go.
Yeah,
it ain't over yet, but Minna's a lock for the bronze medal.
So 54.83 coming through there for Rika as we move on and back round to Japan. Third and final run for Hinano Kasaki. Rolling in backside. Getting that speed, pumping over the hip.
Currently in our
silver
medal position.
So there it is.
Well, hey.
Missing that one.
We saw her all put it all together in run number two.
I think maybe the pressure was on there, and she knew that it would be taking out her teammate, right?
That was some amazing skateboarding. Super powerful. Did all the big transitions.
But 93.20 on the board and finishing score is so insane, Chris.
And now we've got
the victory
gold medalist run.
Starting off, as we've seen before, backside nose grind, backside air, onto that flat bank. Backside flip again.
We call this a victory lap.
But she's not holding back either. It's already in the bag, but still putting on a great show. There's that cradle slide.
Showing you her consistency. Ooh. Popped in on that nose grind. Get it, Kokona.
Kickflip Indy, switching it up.
I like that. I like that she went for that.
Trying to step up her own score. Trying to beat herself there.
Yeah, she didn't need that, but that's great that she went for it.
So there we have run 3 of 3 for Kokona Hiraki. It was a victory lap, that one. And our new world champion, Chris.
Yeah, it's amazing. Look at that top three, all scores in the 90s. Kokona, I believe she was first in qualifying. She was first in semifinals, I know that. And tops it off again in the finals with the first place.
She's certainly consistent, Chris. And you've got to be at this level of skateboarding, Chris, to be able to get anywhere near those 90 scores really shows that everyone has smashed it so much. And it's amazing to see the level of women's skateboarding skyrocketing at the moment.
Yeah,
I'm so stoked.
For sure. And the last year or two, Kokona's really come into her own. She's a force.
So stoked. What a final, Chris. Ooh. You know, some of these skaters have had to go through qualifying, then semifinals, then finals. Wow, this is how it has ended up. Sakura down there in eighth place with that 83.53. Middle of the pack, we see Naya Lasso stoked from Spain. And Rika Ventura just missing that podium. That means that third place goes to Ministes. Second place, Hinano Kasaki. And first place, and our new world champion, 94.54, Kokona Hiraki. And it is time to go to Samantha Bruce, who's on the platform with Kokona Hiraki.
Omete to gozaimasu! So, world champ, how does it feel?
It's my first time being a world champion, so I'm super stoked.
And you're the only skater to land a 94. What was your thought process?
I can hear that. Yeah.
Okay, no worries. And backside kickflip with no grab. How difficult was that to land?
Yeah, the plan was to do that on the second run if I landed the first one, so I'm glad I got to land that.
Yeah. Arigato gozaimasu! And back to you guys.
Thanks very much, Sam. Looking so stoked down there, and it is really loud on that platform, Chris. Everybody's still screaming and super hyped to be out here in Rome. Let's check out some of the highlights from our women's final top three.
Minna. Dropping in with some authority there.
Tweaking those grabs.
Yeah, Minna just has a super fun style, so that's really special when she does well in competition.
Yeah, and second place has gone to Hinano Kasaki.
When's the last time you've seen a wraparound air?
Yeah, you just don't see that trick. One from way back in the 80s. Look at that powerful frontside Smith all the way around that corner. The Andrecht and that cradle slide on the end. That was what saw it off.
I got it.
And first place.
Gold medalist right here.
New world champion. Goes to Kokona Hiraki. There's that backside flip. Frontside nose grind through that deep end corner up on that pool coping.
I like Smith grind. Feeble transfer over the spine. One of the only skaters to use that obstacle.
Yeah, not many people choosing to go over that spine. And there's the stale fish. Reva onto the bank. Right on the buzzer, I think, on that second run to get that super high score.
Yes. How does it feel, world champion?
Yeah, incredible, I'm sure. So stoked to see this competition happen You can see the stands are absolutely packed.
Team Japan, first and second.
Yeah. It's a Japanese and American podium. And it's been great to call this one with you. Still to come, we've got our men's semifinals later, Chris.
Yeah, that is going to go off. Take what you want, eh? Take what you want, say what you want to say. Just another day to decide if this the game you want to play. Make what you want, take what you want to, eh? Take what you want, say what you want to say. Just another day to decide if this the game you want to play, yeah. Spit it into the tape clip. Get a grip, we lift up, no spaceship. A part of me, keep rhymes in harmony like take six with lines you can't fix. Face first, this verse give you a facelift. It's an art when I start to paint drips from a canvas. Oh, it's so good to see some of those highlights, Chris. It's been incredible, and it's only going to keep going that way. Some of the highest scores we've ever seen on the board, Chris, right? Yeah, 94.54. It's just amazing to see the progression in the women's field. It really is.
Yeah, we've still got our men's competition to come, and some of the biggest names in skateboarding are out here in Rome, and some absolute powerhouses. I'm so stoked to see what's going to happen, Chris.
Yeah, hold on to your seats. With how exciting the women's was, the men's is it's going to be heavy.
And our top three from our last World Championships are in the final again. So let's check out what they did to get through last time. Kicking it off with Pedro Barros. Pedro,
yes.
The power.
Powerhouse.
Barros.
The most decorated skater in park terrain right here. But he skates it all. The streets, puts out video parts. It's an animal.
He knows how to work every inch of
There's
the park.
Straight into a 540.
Crouching that one out. Okay, he can stay on it, but he can generate so much speed, Chris.
Yeah, and he's so powerful that tricks can kind of go a little awry, but he can power through it and make it work because he's just got so much strength.
Such a big ollie up to Smith.
Yeah.
And then that ollie down over that hip. I stood up on top of that quarter pipe. It's
massive.
Into
the 540. Crowd went nuts. Pedro is always a crowd favorite.
And that
with
was
so
good
much
enough
passion.
For that bronze medal, Chris.
Yeah, into it.
So let's check out what Augusto Akio did to get that silver medal.
Very smooth style. Dropping in a big 540 there.
Yeah, it's kind of a way more relaxed style than Pedro.
Yeah,
that fakie
wow.
heel flip's so
heel
good.
Flip.
Back
yeah,
Smith
super,
over the hip.
He looks super chill, but he's doing really, really difficult tricks. Wow, that was like a frigid crail air. I've never
and he's
seen
got a
that.
Completely different approach to skateboarding and like his outlook on life as well.
For sure.
There's that nolly 180 switch crooked grind, taking it down into that pool end. Such a good
Smith.
Big Smith grind, yeah. And then that mute 540 Woo. Over the hip. Back-to-back tricks
grab.
Like that is why he ended up in that silver place position. And that backside Smith, 270 out, that revert was so good. You see his face there like, whoa! So, so good. But here we have the amazing Jagger Eaton,
Woo,
who took that world champion title out in Sharjah. There's that kickflip, backside lip slide, frontside air. Ollieing up to backside Smith grind. And Jagger really, really shone in this competition. He stepped it up every run. He put a new little trick in.
Yeah.
Or did a trick differently, like maybe kickflipped in on every run. It was so good to see.
That's what the judges want to see. They don't want to see repetition. Big Indy 540 there. Straight into the heel flip, Indy. Signature trick, blunt kickflip out. At that point, he was in the books.
Yeah, so stoked, and that's what it took to take that first place in the gold medal. Jagger Eaton is definitely a force to be reckoned with. Chris, the atmosphere out here last night was through the roof. It was electric. Absolutely incredible, yeah. Especially when Alex Sorgente and Alessandro Mazzara dropped in, right?
Yes. Doing it for Italy. Crowd really got behind him.
You see it. Alex Sorgente stood up on that platform. I love the way he started off this run with that frontside Smith grind. So good. But unfortunately, he fell on that first run.
Ouch.
But Alex Sorgente is born and bred in the USA, but because he has dual nationality through his dad, he's able to decide to ride for Team Italy.
There's where things went wrong. That half cab, I think it was going for a feeble.
Nico all the time because we are live and we follow the TV signal.
That's where he missed that cab 50-50.
Roma, vi chiedo un applauso. Inizia in 15 minuti. Ultimi per ora di warm up. Dopodiché, finale.
Ciao a tutti, sono Alex Sorgente, benvenuto a Ostia Skatepark per la campionato mondiale del skateboarding.
Being part of Team Italy is special. We are so close, we support each other.
Sapristi's team is born from nothing. We were just traveling, me and Daniele were traveling around the world for doing small contests.
They're awesome, they've been great to me. And it's really cool too because it just was like a natural thing to come into the team and it all worked out really well, so I'm really stoked to be a part of it.
We have a really, I think, small scene in Italy. But it's getting better now. More guys and more girls starting now skating.
For park, the culture is really small. We're not a lot. I have to travel a lot for skate with the people that do what I do, skating park.
I feel like the last 2 or 3 years, park skating has definitely like progressed a lot in these competitions. Every time I come to a contest, there's some new kid with some new trick, and yeah, everyone's just pushing the limits, going bigger and faster than before. So it's really cool to watch and really cool to be a part of as well. And yeah, I'm just trying my best to keep up, you know?
Having Sorgente in the team is so cool. He's a funny guy. He's always there for us.
For me, Sorgente is like a brother. He's from Italy. I mean, he lived all his life in Florida or in Americas, but he knows Italian and he's one of us. He's one of my best friends, so I'm really hyped.
My father is from Italy, so yeah, I have dual citizenship. I've had the Italian passport for a little while now. My first introduction to like bowl skating, they built this huge bowl in Bologna, Italy, where my dad's from, and it was the first huge bowl that was like built in Italy by Dreamland Skateparks, and basically learned how to skate bowls from that skate park.
I hope this event will help people start skating park. It's what I love, and for sure you guys will love it, so try, just try it.
Grazie a tutti per essere venuti a vedere la gara, spero vi sia piaciuta.
Hello and welcome. So I'm here with local hero and crowd favorite Alessandro from Italy. Thank you so much for being here with me. Firstly, can you just describe the atmosphere that's here?
Yeah, it's been amazing. I mean, for me, it's the first time to have all this crowd for me, and even for the other ones, they're all super charged, and they're cheering everyone, and it's charging me a lot. I mean, it's best feeling ever.
And so this is the first time that the World Championships is happening in Italy. Can you describe what it's like to have it in your, like, home country?
Yeah, I'm always been used to travel a lot for do contests, even for skating, because we don't have that much here for skate. So it's the best thing ever. I can sleep on my bed, I can be with my friend, and then in 2 minutes I can come here and skate the world champion. So.
And unfortunately, you didn't quite make it into the finals today, but can you talk us through how semis went for you yesterday?
I mean, we had a lot of fun. We're old friends, and we're all super respectful, and I mean, I didn't make it, and that's life, that's skateboarding, works like this, next time for sure.
So you're describing that, unfortunately, that switch blunt flip didn't quite work out for you, but that's something that you might want to put into future runs?
Yeah, for sure. Next contest, I'm going to put it down. I'm going to work on it. I mean, it's really hard to have it unlocked, but I'm going to work for it.
And so, obviously, you're here with the world's best skaters. Does that want to push you to do better?
Yeah, for sure. I want to, when this is finished, I want to take the run off the first and try to do it again. It's going to be, for me, a good work, and I will do it for sure.
Amazing. Thank you so much for your time, and hopefully we'll see you at the next contest.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
Thanks very much, Sam, and thanks, Alessandro. He's got a bright future ahead of him. He's got such a good trick bag, and I would have loved to have seen him in the final, Chris.
Yeah, I loved his laid-back approach. Super positive. Yeah, I like his energy.
Yeah, and the energy of the crowd every time he dropped in as well was, I think the stands might have been severely damaged if it carried on.
Yeah, you heard him. In his hometown, he just had to roll out of bed, basically, and here he is.
Yeah, that's a great opportunity to have, having the World Championships in your back garden, pretty much. And with such a crazy bowl that we've got, there's so many different approaches to how to use it.
Yeah,
and we were lucky enough to catch up with a few skaters earlier today to find out about their approach.
The park is really nice. It has a good flow to it. My way of skateboarding, obviously, I like bigger stuff, so it's challenging, but challenges are fun.
I love the ball. I think it's really special because for me, I can really carry a lot of speed. I can also get really technical. I mean, there's like that midsection where I'm able to do a flick back lip slide, and then the deep end, I can blast fives, and there's a lot of things I can do in this bowl, a lot of possibilities.
I got a line down that I want to do, so I guess now I'm kind of just trying to figure out like extra stuff I could throw in there and see what works and see what's not working, but there's a good flow to it. You can go fast through it, and yeah, it's fun. I like this one.
It's open, but at the same time, you can hit like a bunch of places right after each other. We're seeing a bunch of like different styles of skating. Everybody can do their own thing. There's a lot of possibilities.
You watch like Tom and Keegan and Pedro skate, and they all skate very similarly in the way where it's a lot more vert tricks. And I love that type of skating, but I honestly can never do that. Like, I was never really a vert dog. I skated mega a lot, but I never really skated vert.
I've always skated a lot of vert since I was a little kid, so that's probably where I got a lot of my tricks from. But right now I'm just like trying to bring it all together and like make my own thing, you know?
I'm just a vert skater that can like carve a corner, and that's kind of like, that's really all I got, but same thing.
Winning Sohwon was really special for me. It was like my first international like big contest that I won. Every contest brings like little pressure, and this one, especially for being the World Championship of the year, I'm just trying to not think about this too much and just skate and go with the flow.
I never underestimate any of my competitors. I think that's a huge thing for me is I always know that these guys will rise on the occasion, and I just need to rise with them.
When we have the crowd really cheering on us, when we have screens, when we have people there wanting to see this magical thing that is skateboarding happening to its highest level, it usually happens.
So, Chris, unfortunately, Tom hasn't made it through to the finals, has he?
No, you know, some rare falls from Tom. You know, he skates big transition, as he mentioned, vert skater. Bowls maybe a little small for him, but amazing skating nonetheless. Tom's one of the people that developed this park skating level.
Yeah,
he was one of the founding fathers, even though he's as young as he is. It's really about Tom, Pedro, Alex Sorgente. So stoked to see him out here.
Yeah, but one thing I want the viewers at home to see, and I'd like to see it again, is during practice, Tom did one of the most crazy 540 tail grabs I've ever seen.
Yeah, look at
over
this.
Over the love seat. Look how far
flying
that is. And grabbing it tail, arguably one of the hardest 540 variations there are. I mean, check this view out. Crazy.
Unbelievable.
So good.
I would have loved to have seen him in the finals. And in a small way, we're going to, because he's now down on the course with Samantha Bruce.
Char, another one of the crowd's favourites here. Tom, thank you so much for being here with me.
Yeah,
so let's talk about your journey. You've been to every World Skate event so far. Each park differs. Can you tell us a bit more about this park and how you adapt to each one?
Yeah, this park's really good. I liked it a lot. It flows really well. There's not too much flat bottom or anywhere where you kind of lose speed. So it's pretty easy to kind of come up with a run and kind of do your own thing too.
I mean, as Mark mentioned as well, you didn't quite see you make in semis that huge 540 tail grab over the love seat. I mean, what was going through your head? Were you just having a bad day?
You know, it just happens. It's part of skating. I just didn't land my run, and it's all right, though. I mean, it is a part of it. It really is, so.
And so, as you can see, we're watching some of the VT. Can you just take us through some of your run?
Yeah, I mean, I think, yeah, I fell on a 5 right there. I kind of just fell on stuff that, like, I don't know. I feel like normally I don't usually fall on, but like I said, it really is a part of skating, you know? You can't land everything, and I don't know. There's always another contest, so it's all right.
Cool. And so what will be your mindset going into future events?
I don't know, really. I don't want to change, like, too much of my mindset, I guess, but, like, maybe just a little more practice.
Well, thank you so much for that, and good luck, and we'll see you at the next event.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Sam. Thanks, Tom. Good to hear from Tom there. Yeah, he couldn't quite get it together, and I've always said the only person who can beat Tom is Tom. You know, he just goes absolutely crazy, and he does some of the biggest tricks that you'll ever see in practice, right?
Yeah, definitely. And I dare to say this park is a little small for Tom, who really shines on big transitions. Big vert.
Yeah, and you can see on screen right there, Augusto Akio, who we caught up with earlier in the competition, and he's certainly an amazing person to speak to.
And first time I saw a skateboard was on TV. Since I have my first board, I started skating in front of the house. Also, my father introduced me to this idea of competition, contest, because he knew it that it's a place that everyone who goes in a skateboard contest at least likes skateboarding. Everyone share the same, how can I say, ideal, the same gusto. My family always supported me on skateboarding. That's what brought me to this high level. When I'm doing a contest, it's not just fun session. It's an opportunity to show what I know. It's a cool vibe because of all those riders, all those skaters. Everyone who skates maybe has something to teach me, and everyone who wants to be with me maybe can learn something with me too. Skateboarding, for me, it means a way to see the world, a way to connect with people, a way to connect with places. Is part of me.
Such a great outlook on skateboarding and on life. And yeah, it really is an amazing thing. I definitely think if you're thinking of starting to skateboard, you definitely should. Don't hold back. But let's take a look now at how our semi-finals went down for our men.
In men's semi-finals, the pressure was on from the beginning. Heat number one was stacked with familiar names who had to put it all on the line to claim a top eight spot. Crowd favourite Stephen Pinheiro only completed his first run posting an 84, a dangerous score that saw him miss the finals. Local hero Alessandro Mazzaro was outstanding in the quarterfinals, but maybe the pressure of expectation from the Italian crowd proved too much.
super impressive Tate Carew is blunt sliding around the pool coping in the deep end and had a wild last run, including tail grab 540, but appeared hurt afterwards. Despite having had three full runs of 87 or above, Jagger Eaton was clearly not happy with the scores he received and will need to tweak his runs to have a shot at defending his title. Australian Kiefer Wilson came back from a heavy slam in his second run to stick two 540s in his last run. Luigi Cini, who won the last stop in Argentina, was awarded the only 90 score of the men's semis with a run that included a 360 flip stalefish over the volcano, which looked like a bail until he grabbed it and brought it home. Heat 2 kicked off with Augusto Ikeo, who came second in the 2022 World Champs. He blew his first two runs and needed his third to post an 87 and progress. Tom Shaw went to the highest and fastest but couldn't complete a run despite having traveled to practice here twice in advance. Yuro Nagahara has been super consistent all week but needed a Hail Mary last run to go through and knock Stephen Pinheiro off the bubble in spot number 8. International crowd favorite Pedro Barros is back in a big way, opening his runs blasting and ending them with switch maneuvers, really mixing it up for the judges and impressing the crowd.
Chris, semi-finals was bonkers yesterday, and watching that back, it was so tense.
Yeah, it was mental. That Pedro ending off with Pedro Barros was so powerful.
He was sitting in that first place position for quite a while, and then Luigi came through and just put that run together that was bonkers.
Yeah, Luigi's got a couple really unique, difficult tricks in his bag.
Yeah, we are in for a right treat, so let's take a look at who is going to be in our men's finals. So we'll be kicking it off with Kiefer Wilson, taking it to Augusto Ikeo, Pedro Barros, Yuro Nagahara, Tate Carew, and then into our top three qualifiers, Jagger Eaton, Gavin Bottger, and Luigi Cini qualifying in that first place position. Now, Chris, someone who impressed me from yesterday was Gavin Bottger. He seems so comfortable, but the style, execution of his tricks, you see him dropping in there.
Yeah.
I'm really excited to see what he's got for us because I've caught a couple of run changes that he's done so far. And I don't want to give anything away, but I think he's going to give Luigi a run for his money.
100%. I mean, Gavin busted on the scene as a little Grom. Placed first at Dew Tour 2020, kind of came into his own and blew everyone's mind.
Yeah, 100%. I'm really excited. But at this stage of the game, anyone who is in the final right now could take that world champion title.
They've all got the tricks.
But someone's going to want to keep hold of their title, and that is definitely Jagger Eaton as we go into our first run of our men's finals at the World Championships of Park Skateboarding here in Rome. Wow, we're starting it off big time with Kiefer Wilson.
Tail slide. Oh, high-speed nose grind.
So Kiefer did that yesterday. He almost went too fast for the nose grind and just ended up doing a little bit of a nose bonk.
Yeah. Getting those first run jitters out, hopefully.
So that's run one out of the way for Kiefer. And we have seen it from everyone, even the experienced guys. They get nervous for run number one, don't they?
Yeah, you sure do. So sort of all the waiting with the women's field. Got to warm up.
And we just heard from the amazing Augusto. Dropping straight
nice.
In, kickflip indie. Look at that line pumping over the hip.
Positive attitude. Backside lip slide up.
That's the kind of trick that could really cause you a problem, right? You can stick on that backside lip slide, but he makes it every time.
Yeah, and then that big stand-up nose grind was sick as well. Into the nose blunt.
That really is the trick of the competition, that nose blunt. There's the backside air. Coming out over the love seat, nolly tail slide. Up to front side, Smith grind coming down to the last 5 seconds.
Ooh. Run feeble off the extension, that was sick.
Oh, this one's going to be after time, it seems.
Ah. See, we talked about that timing. Stoked, it's a great run, but he wants to get to that 540.
Yeah, so he's going to have to hustle, maybe
make a little adjustment.
So that's run number one for Augusto Aquino for Brazil.
Super positive attitude. It's amazing.
So this is how run number one went. Taking it into the deep end. There's that backside air around the corner.
This is where it looked like he might have missed a trick or gotten lost to set up for that 540.
And I mean, these guys practice these lines so much that as soon as you don't make the trick the way you want it to, it can really throw you off, can't it?
Yeah, even how you land.
All right, score is at 84.5.
Still, respectable score. Great first run.
Great score for run number 184.50. As we take it to fellow teammate, the amazing Pedro Barros.
Bringing the power and the love.
Chris, I think we are going to see the Pedro to the metal. This is going to be bonkers.
Buckle up. Enjoy the Pedro show.
If you've got a seatbelt on your armchair at home, please stick it on right now.
Get it, Pedro.
Big speed. Woo! Huge indie to start things off.
Oh, my Lord.
Sucking up that
just
landing.
Powered through that.
Wow.
Huge
such a big snailfish. 540. Chris, I said it earlier. We were having a chat about how we thought this thing was going to play out. And I said, he's not going to hold back.
Yeah.
And he will either do the best run that you have ever seen him do today, or he's going to throw himself so high like that snailfish then that he's just going to blow it out. I mean, sucking up the landing from there, that is so, so crazy.
Oh, man. Yes. Getting some props from his dad, Andre. Been out to their hometown of Florianopolis. Such an amazing scene out there in Brazil.
Okay, we're taking it over to Japan and Euro Nagahara, run number one of three. 45 seconds on the clock. He's looking pretty focused.
What a Euro.
Straight into that big backside ollie.
High speed in the air. Big old 540. I like how he put that 540 in the middle of his run, making sure he got to it.
Yeah, some people save those to the end of the run, but we're seeing a lot of those mid-runs. So that's where he fell off yesterday in our semi-finals. So it's good to see that he's gone back to that, because he didn't choose to go back to it during the semis. But unfortunately falling off at the end of that run. Good to see Jaime in the crowd there enjoying the vibes.
Euro's got what it takes for sure.
Yeah, and I like the line that Euro does, where he rolls out onto the platform and Ollie's back in to the flat bank. And that's what the judges were saying they need to see. They want you to use every inch of this course. So 72-76 coming through for run number one, and that sees him in second place. But we are taking it back to the USA for Tate Carew right now, run one of three. I love the way he starts that run, backside roll into the deep end.
Into that big backside Smith grind.
Oh, wow. Every go, burial 540 as well.
Combo.
Back-to-back tricks so far.
Placed fourth in San Juan, so he knows how to do it.
Blunt slide.
There it is.
He had some problems with that yesterday. He looks like he's worked on that this morning. Blunt side nose grind. Keep it going. Take 5 seconds. Alley-oop tail grab. Bit squirrely on the landing. I think this one's after time. Front blunt. If he can get to that, Chris, that's a dangerous run, I think.
Yeah, that was still an amazing run. I dare to say that's the highest score we've seen so far.
Yeah, full run there, getting some props from Stephen Pinheiro in the crowd. And that's one thing, Chris, you see everyone's out here. Alex Sorgente's in the crowd as well. Everyone comes out. Let's go, Tate.
It's the world championship, buddy.
So, eagerly watching those scores. Let's check out the replays.
That's like a hard flip indie grab. So crazy. And then body varial 5.
There's
and that's
that
the
long
thing with Tate, is
slide.
He's doing one trick to be able to give him the ability to do the next. Do you know what I mean? His board's backwards, so he's going body burial 540.
Super difficult tricks.
86.37, you called it. It was the highest score so far.
That's got to be such a relief.
Yeah, get the solid run down and be like, okay, I've got a completed run
now
on
I
the board.
Party.
Now it's time to start working on something else. Okay, drop it in right now. Third place qualifier and defending world next champion runner. From the USA, we have run 1 of 3 for Jagger Eaton.
Such a fierce competitor.
Whoa, switching that line up. Backside 360 Indy over the
first time we've seen that.
Fakey lip slide round the corner, backside on a yoli.
Ooh, frontside half gap blunt. Oh, there's that kick foot back lip slide every time. Love that trick.
Up to nose blunt. He's looking super focused, Chris. Indy 540. Oh, slipping out the back. You can see the disappointment there.
He is a fierce competitor, man. Anybody can back that up. Make things work.
That's looking like a great run. We said it yesterday. What's he going to do to switch it up? And he started off with that Indy 360 over the love seat.
That was
huge.
That's
a long way to travel. We saw Tom's tail grab 540 earlier. Yeah. But landing fakie over that
over
thing
that
is really
with
scary.
The coping and everything, the clearance you got to make.
All right, so next year,
amazing.
Out of the USA.
Okay, we're staying with the USA right now, and we've got run 1 of 3. Second place qualifier from yesterday's semi-finals. Here's Gavin Bottger. Let's see it, Gavin.
Yeah,
huge frontside air front into the corner.
They call him Gavo. Oh, no.
Oh, no way.
No comply tail.
That's going to be time on run number one. Maybe some first run nerves, maybe, Chris?
Yeah, I mean, you know, these guys had to wait it out for a whole nother competition, so they're probably just getting loose.
Really keen to see a full run.
He's laughing. Gotta have fun, that's for sure.
Two more tries left, and that takes us round to our first place qualifier out of Brazil. Run number 1 of 3 for Luigi Cini. I'm excited to see how he's going to change up that qualifier run, Chris.
Yeah.
He's got such a crazy and deep bag of tricks.
Yeah, he placed first at our San Juan event, and you're going to see why.
Yeah, into the deep. There's the kickflip Indy, traveling really far over that hip.
Nice use of the spine.
Back into the deep end.
Huge 540.
Yeah, that was way up there. Slapping the tail on the way in. That shows full control there on the tail grab.
Fun people through that corner. The kickflip stalefish, yes! Just hung on to it.
There's not many people that do that one, Chris.
No. And the back tail with the extension. Here we go. Ah!
Down for that 360
flip. That 360
stalefish.
Stale in time, but unfortunately didn't happen. We saw that in the semifinals.
So I think this is going to be a heavy score for a full, which will give us a little bit of a flavor of what's to come for that full completed run.
I agree with you.
The judges are heavily docking those scores when you don't complete the run, Chris.
Yeah, but like you said, there was so many difficult, unique tricks in there. I think that still scores fairly well.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, there you go.
76.97 coming through there for run number one for Luigi.
Luigi getting some props from Pedro.
So we're taking it back to the top of the heat where we started. Run number two. And we're kicking that off with Kiefer Wilson. 45 seconds on the clock. Taking it onto the steep flat bank. Oh, missing that kickflip frontside air.
Massive.
He is not holding back. You can see it. He's focused and he's like, you know what? This needs to happen.
Yeah, it's got to come together. That last run.
So back to Augusto Akio from Brazil, run 2 of 3. You can hear the crowd going wild.
Yeah, currently in the podium position.
84.50 on the board. Starting it off in the deep end. Nose grab five.
Big wrap around air.
Out to back 50-50. Don't think he got the line that he wanted out of there, but maintaining the run. That was so good. Looks like he's a bit lost, Chris, and just throwing down the huge trick bag he's got wherever he wants anyway.
Yeah, sort of saved things with that kickflip indie there. Recovered well.
He's trying to get that nolly 180 switch.
The switch crooks, yeah.
So the pressure's on now for heat number three to get that different run that he wants, but currently sitting in that second place position, he's looking good in the silver medal position. So we're staying with Brazil. Our next rider up is going to be the powerhouse,
Pedro
Barros. He loves a bit of crowd participation.
Yeah.
And it's getting hard to even hear myself talk down here. The stands are loud as I've ever heard. And here we go. Run two of three. 45 seconds on the clock for the amazing Pedro Barros.
Yeah, he puts 110% in every wall.
Tweaking that in the air to start things off. That's the line that he wanted. Are we going to see the stale foot five?
Yes, we are.
Okay.
This time.
He's going to be buzzing right now. Alley-oop in the air.
Whoa.
From 50-50 through the corner. That sets him up for the kickflip in the Chris. Here we go.
Get it, Pedro.
The Pedro show.
Yes.
So
very
solid on that landing.
It was so difficult. And here he's going for the switch 50, I think. Here it is. Here it is.
Hang on. No. He was trying to stay on no matter what. He's stoked anyway. Taking a bit of a gnarly slam, but he doesn't mind. He's like, yeah, we'll get it in the next one. That was exciting, Chris.
Yeah,
I don't think I'm going to be able to speak tomorrow. This is going crazy already.
That was heavy.
Great run there from Pedro.
Just got to get around to that switch 50. We've seen him do it numerous times.
He said thank you to the crowd.
All right.
The way he started off that run, the indie air, and he just tweaked it, the real Pedro way, you know, only he does it like that. So good. 81.07.
Okay.
Stepping that score way up and sitting in that bronze medal position with a fall, Chris.
Get some props from his dad, Andre, there.
Okay.
Pedro never takes the easy road.
Out of Japan,
we have run number two for Yuro Nagahara.
All right.
He's saying, come on, let's hear it.
I like it. It is electric out here.
Yeah, you can barely hear a thing. He's starting off with that backside ollie, that feel-good factor, tweaking that in the air into the deep end. Chris,
huge,
he's on
540.
It.
Ollie 5-0 up the extension. Get a Euro. So high speed there. Nice combination.
Ollie 1 foot, keeping it. Old school, missing the kickflip, Indy. Okay. So 72.76 on the board already for run number one. It's going to be around that score, I think, for run number two, maybe lower. So that means the pressure is going to be on for
run number three.
But if we see that full run, Chris, we could see that podium start shuffling around.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting because it's all coming down to the third run. This leaderboard completely changed.
Yeah, 59.45 coming in. Still sat in that fifth place position as we take it back to the USA. And run number two of 3-4-10. Tate Carew.
In our first place position right now.
Back Smith grind over that love seat. There you go.
There we go.
Straight to that barrier five.
Oh, frontside air. That was crazy. Get it, Tate.
Back down into the deep end.
There's that blunt slide, high speed, all the way through the corner. There's a nose grind.
He's grinding so fast then on that.
Oh, you peel for Bandy. Get it, Tate.
What? Crouch in the landing out. Alley-oop tailgrab 540.
Grab 540 up the extension. That was special.
Wow, real special. Tate is on fire right now with run number two.
Yeah, just when you thought he already done everything he could possibly do. That alley-oop 540 was just crazy.
Yeah, so, so good.
Hey man, that's what skateboarding is all about. Lay it all on the line. It's that crazy heel flip, hard flip, straight into the burial 540.
Seems to have worked out the problems he had with that blunt slide from yesterday, and he's getting it every time through that big corner. And this is where we saw the end of the run.
Yeah, that's a first.
Smashed it out of the park right there. So spinning the opposite direction that he's turning and grabbing the tail with the 540. That's an alley-oop.
Yeah, I think tail grab fives are really arguably the hardest grab.
So let's see how he's going to be rewarded for that run from our judges. 91.34 and extending his lead. And in gold position, we have the amazing Tate Carew.
Wow. But in the driver's seat.
Coming
now.
Up next, we have out of the USA, defending world champion, Jagger Eaton. We saw him fall on that first run.
Doing it for the hard supply.
Here we go.
He's going to Shillerif.
He's going to respond to that in a heavy way, I'm thinking. Indy 360 over the love seat. It's him spotting that corner pocket with the fakie lip slide as he rode out.
That big backside 180. Saw that combination, run number one. Yes.
I really don't know how Jagger has got that kickflip backside lip slide so, so consistent.
Gotta stay on.
Okay.
Indy 5.
He's going to be stoked to have got that one out of the way. That's where he fell before. That's the backside nose blunt. Are we going to see the blunt kickflip? Yes, we are.
Yeah.
And he did it really, really well, Chris. He landed so high up on the transition. Woo. He is so, so stoked on
that
run.
I'm blown away he got to that blunt kickflip. There was so much that went down in that run.
So qualifying
like the competitive intelligence to get to that trick at time.
Yeah, I mean, we mentioned it earlier. The timing of these runs is something that just blows my mind. It's,
yeah.
You know, you're seeing last tricks done right on the buzzer, and it's so, so well planned out. Let's check out that run number two for Jagger.
I talked to him at Phoenix Am. He sat in the booth with us, and he's explaining to me, like, he knows exactly what walls he's going to hit. You know, at that park, he was like, I hit six different directions. So he's definitely timed his run, and it's all planned and went as he executed what he wanted to do very well.
He made that look way, way too easy.
Yeah.
If you're watching at home,
don't see anybody else doing that.
Get lulled into a false sense of security. Skateboarding is not that easy. 88.33. And that sees him jump up into that second place position. But you know he's going to be saying, okay.
Yeah.
I now know what I've got to do to get him
up
to that goal.
3 points.
So run number two, also from the USA. We've got the amazing Gavin Bottger.
Yeah, this dude's a little fireball, man. Huge frontside air.
Stein in that lead melon tweaker, crossbone.
There it is. No papaya tail slide. He missed first time around.
Oh, we saw that in qualifiers, Chris. And he did the alley-oop kickflip indie, but he nose-bones it as well. That shows such control.
He's so
that
in control.
Trick. Proper frontside invert as well.
60 judo. Yeah, Gav, get it.
I love that 50-50
on the up. There it is. Heel flip innie. Gets it.
Gets it done.
Gav, heel flip innie.
Front side grind, last one. Oh, I think if he gets that done, Chris, that is going to shake things up. Don't you think?
Before or after time?
I think it must have been right on the buzzer. Right on, maybe just after. But if he can tidy up that run, that's going to put the cat amongst the pigeons.
100%.
So run number one was way down there. It's definitely just about to improve. Here's that alley-oop kickflip in the nosebone. See him just boning that front foot, getting it straight.
And here's this caballerial heel flip in. Perfectly timed.
So, waiting for that score to come in. 83.06, okay. See him climbing that board, but just off of podium position.
Yeah,
but
he's got to get to that last trick.
84.50 is the score to beat to get on that podium, Chris. And I think with that body barrier, I mean, 450.
He can definitely do it.
Yeah, that's,
definitely do
that
it.
Could do it. So we're back round to number one qualifier. Currently in sixth place position with the 76.97. It's time for Brazilian Luigi Cini. Starting off with that backside Smith grind and taking it into the deep end with the India.
Massive India. Good for Benny. Massive. 540 right there.
Taking the tail grab over the hip on the spine.
Nice front feeble.
That was a big front feeble and missing the kickflip stale fish.
Just got away from him. He's got one more run.
Yeah, one last try to tie to get that done. Definitely doesn't want to be down there in sixth place.
Definitely capable of winning this whole thing. Just got to stay on final run.
Well, I said it before, Chris, anyone in this final could take that world champion spot. But now is the time we find out who's going to be doing it.
Yes. Last and final runs. Get it, keeper.
But Kiefer Wilson, it's all or nothing at this point. Kickflip frontside air.
Tailside up the extension. There's that high speed nose grind.
Oh, come on, Kiefer, keep it going. Down into the deep end.
Now the appeal flip inny.
Whoa, so well done.
Aerial kickflip inny, so sick.
Oh, missing the kickflip. Five. Oh, that means that's going to be it for Kiefer Wilson. But definitely put on such a great show this weekend, Chris.
Ozzy. He went for it, man. Nothing to be ashamed of. Relatively new name on the scene. Amazing job making all the way through competition. Fourth round to the final.
64.67 coming in. That was shaping up to be something dangerous, I think.
Yes,
I think
you said
some
it.
Of the other
Anyone
riders
could
worried.
Win this contest, any of these eight names.
So, third and final run.
The juggler. I love it.
Always putting on a show and always a big smile on his face. For the last time, we're going to see Brazilian Luigi. Sorry, Augusto Aquino dropping in. Come on, Augusto.
You can hear the crowd.
Such an absolute beast on a skateboard. Can really, really turn it up when he needs to.
That gap up, backside lip slide. Alley-oop in the end of the hip. Hip of crab.
Oh, power sliding up into that sugarcane.
That was sick.
Ah, missing the kickflip. Melon around the corner.
Currently in third place. Amazing job.
Yeah, great skateboarding as always. Not quite getting it together in that third and final run. But you can see the first run with that 84.50 was enough for third
and the crowd race. Hanging that Brazilian flag. Luis Francisco as well. Shout out.
third run here in the finals.
Thank you.
It's the Pedro show. Someone that thrives on the pressure and the crowd.
So, for the last time, the third and final run for Pedro Barros.
Electrifying. Let's see it, Pedro.
The crowd is going wild. They know what he's capable of. We're yet to see a full run from Pedro, but he is currently in fifth place with 81.07. Here we go.
Massive in the air, hanging on. Huge Steelfish 540, yeah, Pedro.
Saw him landing a little bit squirrely on the India, but still recovering really well in that front 50-50.
Yeah, that's that power I was talking about. Ah!
And missing the kickflip Indy over the volcano.
Nothing
massive respect for the amazing Pedro Barros.
Yeah, man, he always goes out giving it his all, 110%. One of the innovators in park skating.
Yeah, he's really set the level for where this style of competition has gone. He's going to send the helmet out to the crowd.
That's awesome.
Going to one of the youngsters. He's stoked.
That kid is hyped.
Thank you. Watch out for Pedro. Thank you, Pedro. All right. Next skater out from Japan.
Okay, fourth place qualified through to our finals. Third and final run for Euro Nagahara.
Needs a perfect run right here.
Yeah, it's all or nothing right now, Chris.
Big kick for Bindi over the love seat.
So switched it up already. There's the India into the deep end.
Woo! Big 540. Stay on, Euro.
Front feeble.
Big 1 foot. Yeah. Kick of Japan. Yes. All right. 15. Didn't get the 50-50, but he made the tail slide.
Oh, slipping off the back of that backside 360 over the volcano.
How he does that Indy 360 over that small volcano is pretty nuts.
Chris, you could see then, I mean, he started off differently, did the kickflip Indy, but you could see it was like, okay, I'm in seventh place.
Yeah.
I need to throw everything and the kitchen sink in this.
100%. You got to do everything and then some.
Okay. Wait for that last score to come through. 78.67 with a fall. That's a huge score with a fall. And it's now time to take it round to our first place leader at the moment. Out of the USA, we have Tate Carew.
Yeah, our top four right here. Tate sitting in cruise control, but we will see what happens.
Big backside Smith to kick things off, taking it through to the deep end.
Super unique hill foot, hard foot, Indy, barrel five. Get it, Tate.
Coming back into the deep end, big rock slide. Popped out of that so good, Chris.
Yeah. This is a great run. Oh, went for the front blunt slide. I backed that.
Yeah, trying to step it up from that second run, but currently sat in that first place position as we take it down to the last three skaters in our men's finals.
Yeah, does that score hold?
Who wants a setup?
Awesome.
Yes!
Yeah.
Stoked! See people starting to congregate around that area now. I want free stuff. 72.07 coming through, so staying with that run number two score of 91.34. Okay, our final three skaters of our men's finals, defending Jagger, world champion, third and final run for Jagger Eaton.
Yes, previous world champion, currently in second.
Starting off with that Indy 360 over the love seat, fakie lip slide all the way around the corner.
There's that big backside 180. I've got blunt. Get it, Jagger.
Kick flip backside lip slide.
He's gunning.
Yeah, you can see the focus on his face.
Nice. 85.
Landed that really smooth, high up the transition as well.
Okay, here we go. Is he getting around the blood flip?
Are we going to see the change up here? Yes, we are. Oh, no way. Just missing that kick. Frontside flip out of the blunt.
Yeah, we saw the blunt kickflip fakie. I like how he tried to step it up right there.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I mean,
amazing.
Having seen what it takes put down, dropping in, going, okay, I've got to switch it up. And that blunt frontside flip is definitely one that would have boosted that score.
He is a super, super smart competitor. Got a lot of heart. There you see him giving away his setup. Great showing. Yeah, Jagger Eaton.
Yeah, Jagger always impresses me, and he certainly has again out
he's
here
intense.
In Rome.
He's not playing around.
Okay, we're down to our last two riders, and this could certainly shake things up. We've got third and final run for Gavin Bottger.
Give it, get it, Gabbo.
Currently in fourth place. I want to see a full run from Gavin as the lead melon.
There it is. No comply tail slide. Get it, Gabbo. Alley kickflip Indy.
Get the nose bone out of that again. Big frontside Smith grind around that deep end corner.
Woo! 540 in the frontside invert. Nice combo. Chino 360, yes.
That line is so good.
The escalator back 180 in. Yes!
Caballero heel flip Indy. Frontside grind. Are we going to see it? It's in time.
Yes!
We see it go down. Wow! Gavin Bottger. All the power in the final hour right there. Yes, the crowd has gone wild. We're going wild in the booth as well.
Good thing this thing is almost over. I lost my voice. That was insane.
Wow. So, so stoked. But where's that going to sit him, Chris?
It's tight. It's tight.
On the edge of my seat right here.
94 from Tate Carew. Does that best that. They're homies regardless.
I think our top three are worried right now. So this is where we saw that run end. Wow. You saw that just alley-oop yesterday, but to put the extra turn on, that's something special, and there is literally no one doing that trick.
No, into that tight volcano. It's amazing.
Okay, where's this score? 94! Yeah. 0-3! Wow! Look at the shock on his face,
oh,
and
my
our
Lord.
New leader sat in that gold medal position is Gavin Bottger from the USA.
Yeah, Gavo.
It's like, what? Quite so,
highest
quite margin, Chris.
Of the men's competition. Wow.
Wow, that means on the podium right now we have USA on 1, 2, and 3 positions. Wow, one more skater to go. And this is someone who can definitely take someone off the podium right now. Out of Brazil, third and final run for Luigi Cini. The pressure's going to be on though, Chris, right?
Yeah, Luigi's got the moves to do it.
Coming off that win in Argentina. And starting off his third and final run with a big backside Smith.
Big in the air. Kickflip in. Get it, Luigi. Massive 540. Is he going to get to that 360 flip? Stale.
Oh, I really hope so. There's the front feeble all the way through the corner. Kickflip stale fish. He landed that before he'd even taken off then. Full confidence. Missing the back tail, but getting the backside 5-0.
Okay, here we go.
He's got it done! Wow. 360 flip top stalefish.
I was questioning, was he going to get to that in time? And he did.
So, run number one, he missed that. 76.97 though on the board. We could see Jagger getting toppled off. Let's see how the judges are going to react to that run. That was incredible.
I'll tell you what, that definitely gets on the podium, that's for sure.
I am going to need a lie down after this, Chris. This has been crazy.
Hey, this competition ended with such a bang. So good.
And after what we saw yesterday in semifinals, it's really, really hard to think how it could step up, but you know it can.
The Barros family, giving them a hug, well deserved.
That Brazilian bro down looked great right there. So there's that tail grab, slapping it on the way in off of that Melon 5 as well. Boosted it. He's
massive.
Like 2 foot higher than he needs to go, but wants to go higher and higher.
Yeah, and you called it. He's like focused on the next wall before he even lands. So much concentration. And you see that 360 kickflip, stalefish. Boom.
I'd say that was a better execution than we saw yesterday in semifinals well, right?
Yeah, he just squeaked that one out yesterday. That was solid. Well done.
Team Brazil, real high. Look at the tension right now. Oh, this is too much to take, Chris. Such a tense final out here in Ostia, Rome. 91.90. Wow, take Peru pops down into third place and bronze medal, second and silver medal. Going to Luigi Cini, and that means Gavin Bottger way out there in first place with a huge score of 94.03, and your new world champion, Chris.
Yes, Gavin Bottger, only 16 years old. Love to see the camaraderie, country to country. Gavin Bottger, amazing final run, put it all together.
Yeah.
Surprise the crowd and the judges, that's what it's all about.
Literally saving the best till last. So, so good.
What a final.
Yeah, incredible final.
And
unbelievable,
you know, like
skateboarding, and to see people changing up their runs so much, Chris. You could see the tension on the platform.
I mean, they've all got the tricks. Any one of these eight skaters could have won this competition.
So here we have our final standings. Kiefer Wilson in that eighth place position. In the middle of the pack, we've got Augusto Akio and Jagger Eaton just getting knocked off of that podium position on the last run. In that third place position and getting that bronze medal, we have Tate Carew. And on the silver medal position, we have Luigi Cini. And in gold position, and our new Park World champion, the USA's Gavin Bottger. And he's now down on the platform with Samantha Bruce.
Gavin, congratulations. I mean, what a comeback. Last year in 2022, you broke your wrist, but now you're back and you're the new world champion of 2023. You must feel incredible.
I don't even know what to say. This is insane. I'm sorry, I'm speechless.
That's fine. I mean, I can imagine. I mean, everybody was waiting to see what the score was going to be. And I don't even know the name of the trick that you did on that teardrop, but it was like an alley-oop body barrel. I mean...
Yeah, you call it like a round the world, but it's a body barrel, to like fake you, but...
And I've been seeing you trying it in practice, and you weren't quite landing it, but then you just pulled it out the bag now. How did that happen?
I landed a few, like, right before the contest started, but that just, like, kind of helped my confidence, and then... I just like, it's like one in a chance, like, I don't know. I have one time to land it like in this setting, so I gotta do it.
So could you walk us through your journey, how you got from, you know, between Sharjah to here? What's it been like for you?
Just like a lot of sitting around waiting through the healing process and stuff. And then just as soon as I could skate, it was just like skating every day, all day. So,
I mean, now that you've knocked Tate off, are you guys still buddies?
I don't know. Are we still homies?
She's asking if we're still homies.
Bro, of course. this is my brother right here.
Amazing. Thank you so much, guys, and we'll see you the next stop. Yeah. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Sam. Yeah, Gavin. Woo. Of course, they're still homies.
Yeah.
And that's the thing, the camaraderie that we have on the platform. You are giving a hug to the person that knocked you off of the podium.
That's so crazy.
Do you know
crazy.
What I mean?
Yeah.
You know, you might be stood next to the guy that just stopped you from going for the Olympics, maybe, but
yeah.
Skateboarding wins every time, and everybody's stoked to see someone do something really well. And that's, you know, so exclusive to skateboarding, I feel.
Yeah, there is a unique camaraderie behind all the skaters. Great to see.
Yeah, the hype is very, very real out here in Rome. The sun has gone down and the atmosphere has gone through the roof. It's hard to think how it got even bigger than yesterday. Wow, so let's check out our top three runs from our men's finals and our Park World Championships.
Tate Carew, huge, powerful blunt slide.
Yeah, we're sitting in that first place position for a while as well. And it was totally deserved. You can see the hype from the crowd and our silver medalist saving it till the last run. We got Luigi Cini out of Brazil.
Yeah, this was a nail biter. Last run of the competition.
And here we have our gold medalist and our new Park World Champion, Gavin Bottger. Saved it till the last run as well.
Yeah, Gavin.
But this had a little bit of everything, didn't it, Chris?
Oh,
it really
yeah.
did.
Was that around the world, he called it? That's
yeah.
insane.
Alley-oop around the world.
So two USA skaters on podium. The crew is hyped.
Yep, USA and Brazil on our podium. Incredible scenes out here in Rome.
Unbelievable energy.
Yeah, such great energy, and that is going to continue through to our next stop, which is going to be in Japan for our Street World Championship. But will our reigning champions, Aurelien Giraud and Raisa Leal, be able to maintain that lead as we have a pack of hungry Japanese skaters riding on home turf, trying to take away that title of Street World Champion. Kito Horigomi, definitely one of those skaters trying to get it done. Chris, this has been absolutely incredible. I'm stoked to share the booth with you again today, mate.
You too, love my man. It was amazing.
Such
I love
great
what we do
skateboarding
here.
And unbelievably proud of absolutely everyone out there. I'm so stoked to be here and to share the amazing thing that is skateboarding with the world.
Yes.
Thank you very much to each and every one of you for joining us online. We'll see you again in December in Japan for our Street World Championships.
Big love.
Go, make what you want, take what you want, ay. Take what you want, say what you want to say. Just another day, to decide if this the game you wanna play, make what you want, take what you wanna, a, take what you want, say what you wanna say, just another day, to decide if this the game you wanna play, yeah, spit it into the tape clip, get a grip, we lift up, no spaceship, a part of me, keep rhymes in harmony, like take six with lines you can't fix, face first, this verse give you a facelift, it's an art, when I start, the paint drips from a canvas, you asking, I got the answers, the only one to give it, I only spit it with passion. Make what you want, take what you want, ay. Take what you want, say what you wanna say. Just another day, to decide if this the game you wanna play. Make what you wanna, ay. Take what you want, say what you wanna say. Just another day, to decide if this the game you wanna play.